A compulsory cooling off period for all pet purchases could become law in a move aimed at reducing the number of abandoned animals. And as Alice Monfreaks reports, one Salisbury shop owner is taking her own dramatic step to combat the problem.
With faces as cute as this, it's no wonder pet stores do a roaring Christmas trade. But at one Northern Adelaide shop, most cages are empty. Its owner's refusing to sell puppies or kittens during December.
They're stressed about Christmas Day, they're stressed about presents, and I don't think it's a good time for people to make a decision that's going to be part of their life for the next 15 years.
The store fed up with impulse pet purchases. Every year, animal shelters are hit with the aftermath once the novelty wears off.
We get hundreds of calls in January and February, some less so in March, regarding animals that have been dumped post-Christmas.
The pet store instead directing keen customers to the RSPCA. It's already under pressure with more than 150 unwanted cats and kittens and a high number of rabbits, all needing loving homes.
The RSPCA is also looking for volunteer foster carers who can give a temporary home to animals who are too young or sick to cope with a shelter. It's also a perfect way to test run whether you're ready for the commitment that comes with owning one of these.
The pet shop owner calling for all stores to follow her lead.
Hopefully, there is a law that brings in that no animals to be sold November to February.
It could soon be a reality. A parliamentary committee considering laws to stamp out abuse and dumping of animals. A compulsory cooling off period on pet shop purchases also on the agenda.
And that gives the family an opportunity to reflect, is this something that we can really do and do properly?
Mandatory microchipping also slated, so any dumped pets can be traced to the buyer. Alice Monfreys, 10 News.